No. In our last class, we have seen how we can design low pass filter, high pass filter. Then we have talked about band reject filter. Then we have also talked about notch filter, band reject filter, or band stop filter. Okay. And then band pass filter. Okay. We have seen how the placement of the poles and the poles and zeros, they affect the filter response, and we have seen how it can be useful in determining the frequency response of a given system. Okay. Now another important thing is that it is called effect of positioning of the poles, and positioning means radial positioning. Radials means across the radius. Suppose this is a unit circle, right? So we are having real Z, imaginary Z. Now at 45 degree, we have a radius. Okay. Now, what happens if I place a pole across this radius? Okay. If I place a pole across this radius, now this is called effect of radial positioning of the filter. So, say for example, we have a filter which is having the pole at say 0.9 radius, say 0.5 radius, and 0.1 radius. So we all know that whenever we are placing these poles over here at this angle 45 degree, the the consequent frequency which will be affected the most will be the frequency component at this position only, at 45 degree this thing. But due to the change in the distance between the pole and the frequency point, there will be a subtle difference. Okay. Now this difference in the frequency response across this radius, it is regarded as the if you study this, it is regarded as the effect of radial positioning of the poles. And if it is zero, then we call it radial positioning effect of the radial positioning of the zeros on the frequency axis. So today let's check out for a one pole filter what is the effect of the radial positioning of the poles. Okay, similarly you can do the thing for the zeros also. So for the first case, what is the transfer function? The transfer function is h of z equals to, there is no zeros and we have not given any notional gain, so it is 1 by z divided by 1 by z minus of 0.9 angle 45 degree. Okay. So convert this into the rectangular form. Okay. do the pole placement this thing, and you then find out, and then you what? 0.636. Minus 0. Plus plus minus 0.636 J. Okay. So, दोनों माइनस आएगा सर, इट्स इन द फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट, प्लस माइनस ऑफ 0.636. Okay, so you can find out the location, and from there you just put the pole where it is. Then you find out the frequency response. At this moment you just find out the amplitude response. Just find out the amplitude response. Okay. Accordingly, you also find out the response, amplitude response, for radius of 0.5 and radius of 0.1. We are considering that there are no zeros in this system. Okay. Sorry, your this last case. There was a mistake, so it should be at zero at minus 0.9 and 0.9, because I meant this one, right? Then only you will be able to understand what is the effect of this thing, right? So in the third case, please rectify this one. Zero at minus 0.9 and 0.9, and pole at 0.9. Amplitude response for this should be something like this. The blue one is for, say, the radius of 0.9, then it may be something like this for 0.5. And for this thing, for 0.1, it should be something like this, right? So as your pole, it is being placed closer to the frequency axis, you will be having more pronounced effect of that pole on the frequency response. Okay. Similarly, if you place a zero, so what will happen? You will be getting like this. Say this is for 0.9. Say this one is for 0.5, and this is 0.1. Okay. Since zero suppressed again, so the suppression is more pronounced, will be more pronounced if the the zero is placed near to the frequency axis. Now, if you get a question in exam, show the radial effect of radial positioning of the poles and zeros over there. So what you have to do, if it is a 3 marks question, usually my questions you will be having in a question you will be having 2 marks question, 3 marks question and 5 marks question. If it is a 5 marks question, you have to do all the numerical for the poles and the zeros and do this. If it is a 3 marks question, you have to do say for one pole this thing, you have to take at least 3 positions. Okay, you do the numerical, and then for the zero you can just explain the effect. Say for zero it will be something like this. And if it is a just 2 marks question, you just draw the curves that it would be like this, it would be like this, and do it. Okay, so this is one section. Now second is, now the second point is, in our last class you have worked upon an example, a pole at 0.9, right? You have done this. Then you have found out another this thing, pole at 0.9 and zero at this thing, at minus 1, right? You have done that. Now somewhere in between you have talked about placement of a pole over a zero or vice versa will cancel their effects on each other. Now to study that, let's say that let us take a case 1. In the case 1 we have 0 at say plus 0.9, minus of 0.9 and pole at 0.9. Case 2, let's take pole at 0.9 or maybe 0 at minus of 0.9, and in the case 3 you take 0 at minus of 0.9, pole at 0.9 and minus of 0.9. Okay, so while doing this, what you will be getting? In the first instance, you will be getting a pole here and a zero at 0.9. Okay, I am not taking this example, we could have taken. But the thing is that as per the filter design criteria, we cannot place a pole on the frequency axis, right? In the first case, you will be having this pole zero plot. In the second case, you will be having this one. So there is no poles. This is a hypothetical situation, okay? Because we have seen that while we are designing a filter, that filter should have have number of zeros which are greater than poles. But in this case, we have taken only a zero, Okay, so this is just a hypothetical case, okay, to understand the problem of how the placement of the poles over zeros or vice versa, it affects the amplitude response. So this is not a realizable filter. Please keep this in mind. Okay, this is not a realizable filter. And in the last one, you will be having a zero, you will be having a pole, and over the pole you will be having a this thing. So what you will find is that the response of this case 2 and case 3 are same. Okay, and why this is needed? This is needed to the first case is needed just to see what is the effect of a single pole and a single zero over the amplitude response. So at this point, what I would suggest, just take three frequencies, 0, pi by 2 and pi, to determine the frequency response, because it will be easier. All of them except this pi by 2, it will be 0 and pi you will be having as a linear function, right? So it will make your life easy. And also it will just will be forming a right angle triangle, so it will be easier for you to determine the thing. Okay. So please find out the responses of these three filters. Sorry, your this last case. There was a mistake. So it should be at 0 at minus 0.9 and 0.9, because I meant this one, right? Then only you will be able to understand what is the effect of this thing, right? So in the third case, please rectify this one. Zero at minus 0.9 and 0.9 and pole at 0.9. In the last section, we are talking, we have seen that we are writing transfer function as something like this, 1 by z minus a, right? But usually when we write these transfer functions, we usually prefer to change it into a delay form. Delay means z inverse form. Okay, so this transfer function, it can also be written as in the form of z inverse by 1 minus a z inverse. Okay, so why this z inverse? Because when we realize this filter, so when you will be realizing this filter, what will happen? Z inverse means delay. So if you are talking about the current instance input, what is the input in the previous instance, you will need that value. Sorry, it should be the other way around. What was the value in the previous instance? You have to look into that. If it is z to the power minus 2, then you have to move 2 time instances back to find out what is the value. But if it is z, that means In the case of Z, that means it has to take the value of the future instance, which is not possible. Okay, we can predict, but we cannot confidently say that this will be the value at the future instance. Okay, so due to this reason, due to the realization of the filter transfer functions are often represented in this Z inverse terms. Okay, but writing the transfer function in this form is also not incorrect. Okay, so while realization of the filter, which we will be studying post mid-sem, we have to write the transfer function in the Z inverse form, whereas to find the pole and zero positions, we have to convert the transfer function into Z form. Okay, we have to convert the transfer function into the Z form, then only we will be able to get the zeros and the poles. Poles and zeros cannot be calculated using this Z inverse equation. Okay, please keep this in mind. Many students, they do the mistake over here. When I say find out the pole zero plot and this equation is given, they directly start doing this Z inverse equal to this much, so our poles and the zeros will be at this position. But that is not the case. Even if you take this one and compute it to 0, 1 a Z inverse equals to 0, so what you will get? 1 equals to a Z inverse, Z equals to 1 by Z equals to a, Z equals to a. Okay, Z equals to a, and over here also now we are getting in this instance we are getting Z equals to a, but for multiple poles and zeros, this might not we might not get the same response. Okay, so when it is done, because what happens is that when you get this thing, this equation sometimes does not hold good. In this case we are getting the same value. Over here also we get Z equals to a, and from this equation also we are getting this Z equals to a, but it might not be the same in all the cases. So while finding out the poles and the zeros, you have to use this equation, and for this one you have to use this thing. Over here what happens, another important thing, in the zero, so if you plot equals this to zero, so Z inverse equals to zero, so what happens? 1 by Z equals to zero, so Z equals to infinity, right? This is not possible, because if you look into this, what is happening? There is nothing. So since there is no Z terms, so we cannot find out the zeros. So there are no zeros. So see the fallacy of this one. Even though the pole you have got in the same position, at the same location, it is showing that there is a zero at Z equals to infinity, which is incorrect. So see, so for finding out the transfer function of the placement of the poles and the zeros, the location of the poles and the zeros, we have to use this equation, and for realization of the filter, we have to use this second equation. Okay, next, coming to this operation This is again from the book Tompkins. When you have this one, for the finding out of the amplitude response, what you have to do? So in case of Z inverse, see, Z inverse, we have to replace it with e to the power minus j omega t. Okay? So this is the shortest method to find out the amplitude response. You just put it over here, this form, then you break it down, 1 minus 1 by 2 cos omega t plus j sin omega t, t we will be considering as 1, okay. If sampling frequency is given, then t is equal to 1 by sampling frequency, okay, right. At whatever position, suppose you want to find out the value at amplitude response value at pi by 4. You just put the value of pi by 4 over here and you calculate the value and find out the modulus of that. That will be your amplitude response at that particular frequency. Okay. If nothing is given, say it may be said that you find out the frequency response of the filter, of this given filter, by distance method, then you can use either of the two methods. Okay, then you can use either of the two methods. Okay, because this will make your life easier, right? So now if you see, there is a real term and an imaginary term. So it is 1 plus a plus jb. I have already told you how to convert it into the form c plus jb, and then use that equation to find out the phase of the phase response at particular given frequencies. So for each frequencies, for the 5 frequencies what I have told, so 0, pi by 4, pi by 2, 3 pi by 4 and pi, at these 5 frequencies you have to find out this equation, and from this equation you have to find out the modulus and the phase responses. Okay. So that's it for today. Thank you.